Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. In the previous video you have learned PLC basics and how to write a simple program to turn on a motor and simulate a PLC. In this video we will learn PLC wiring and we will download our program to real PLC. I will explain wiring of this motor. The fundamental for other PLCs is similar. We see L1 and N. L1 is for line and N for neutral. They are connected to line and neutral from the power source 120 volts or 220 volts. It is converted to 24 volts and it will provide power for our PLC. Third terminal are connected to earth. Then we have L plus and M. They are output of 24 volts DC. M is common of our inputs and should be connected directly to 1M. L plus we use to wire the inputs, but you need to check your PLC and inputs, whether it is DC or AC. My PLC has 24 volts DC inputs, therefore I can use L plus to wire them. M or black wire is 0 volt and red one is 24 volts. We can connect our start and stop button to one of these 8 inputs. Now we have outputs. They are relay output. If you look at the datasheet or right or left side of PLC, you will see it is written 30 volt DC, 250 volt AC, 2 ampere. It means we can connect digital outputs with 30 volt DC or 250 volt AC to here, and current range is up to 2 ampere. So we connect our 30 volts or 250 volts to 1L or 2L. When outputs are activated, we will have this voltage in these outputs. Next step, we will connect the PLC to PC through LAN cable. One important thing, 1L and 2L can be different. The signal on 1L will come out only from output 0 to 3, and we will have the signal on 2L only on outputs 4 and 5. I show the wiring of inputs in my PLC. Let's create our project in TIA Portal. My PSC has a firmware 1 and I can't connect it to TIA Portal version 16 or 17. I have to update the firmware or use TIA Portal version 13. If you know exactly your PLC name and part number, you can select your PLC in this list. If you don't know your PLC name, select this one and TIA Portal will detect it automatically. Write again simple motor on off program. Now we want to connect the PC to the PLC and download our code to PLC. In the previous video, we used simulation, but this time we want to use real PLC. So we click on the download to device. In this window, you see some information about PLC, type of interface, and IP address. Select for interface Profinet. PNIE. Next, select your LAN card, which PLC is connected. Click on Start Search. It will search everything that is connected to your LAN card and it will find your PLC. It shows the PLC and its IP here. If you check this box, the LED on the PLC will flash on and off. Click on Load. PC asks, do you want to add this IP address to communicate with PLC? If you have administrator right in your PC, click on Yes and it will add the IP automatically and your PLC will be detected. You will see this window just once. Next time TIA Portal doesn't need to search again the PLC. The logic will be downloaded. Here it says it will move the PLC to run mode. Click on Finish. Let's check the program. Click on Go Online and then on Glass to monitor the program. If you press the Start button, output will be latched. If you press Stop button, the output will be turned off. We can see that our program runs correctly. If you don't have administrator right, for example, you work with the PC in your school. If you click on Yes, PC will message you, you have no right to do this. What should we do? I changed the IP of PLC. To change it, here is the LAN interface. Click on it. Down here, if you open this menu up, you can see the IP address of the PLC. I change it. I try to download the program to PLC. PC has this IP address, but the PC is not in this network, and we can click on yes to add this IP. Click on no. PC try to find PSC, but it can't. Here is the solution. Right click on the internet icon and open internet and network setting. Open adapter options. Choose adapter that you have connected your PLC. Open Internet Protocol version 4. Select second one. You have to make sure that first, second, and third part of the IP address are PLC and your LAN card and subnet is same. But last part of the IP must be different. Now we try to download again. You see here the IP addresses are same and we send our code to PLC. This time PLC didn't ask about IP. Thank you for watching this video. In the next video, we will learn together syncing and sourcing inputs of PLC.